Hello and welcome back to our next video of the Game Impression series. We play Close Combat Cross of Iron. For all fans of the series, there's good news. Matrix and Slytherin will redo the whole series with a new Unity engine, so redoing it from the scratch, so there will be many very nice games of Close Combat. We will now check the ones that are already available. Some of them very old, but still redone from Slytherin Matrix, and so I think it's very enjoyable here. We will check now what we can do here. Let's check the close combat options. We can remove trees so we can see our units better. We can remove killed soldiers so we can see easier also how many soldiers are still on the field. We can show different things from our team. We can show health. We can show cover. Cover comes in three colors. Red means no cover, yellow means medium cover, and green means very good cover. We can display all kinds of things here. We have general things. We can choose the game speed from fast to slow. We can always adjust that also during a game. So if it's going to be a very hot fight and we just need to give out many orders, be very careful. We can slow down the whole game. We can set the screen resolution, scroll speed, and the sound volume. We can make the Russians speak Russians and the Germans speak German. And we will just play one single scenario. And that's going to be Barbarossa D-Day. And I will play this time the Russian side. I can put in my name as the commander. The commander is very important as he is helping with the morale and also the performance of his units. If he gets killed, many units may just panic and run off the battlefield. So also the morale is very nicely simulated. We will command the Russians here. We can choose the time, 1 minute up to 99 minutes. We will have 30 minutes right now, so I can show a lot of stuff. The difficulty setting is veteran, that means it's historical difficulty. We can make it harder up to hero or easier up to recruit, which means that we, for example, in a campaign get more support points to rebuild units. Also, they have a higher strength, morale and supplies and all these kind of things. What is very enjoyable about this game too, we can have realism settings, always see the enemy, never act on initiative, always have full enemy info, always obey orders. That all these things are simulated. Soldiers do not always obey your orders. They sometimes have a low morale. And also during the campaign we can upgrade units. We can let them rest, for example, if they need rest. Here we have our units. We can see we can choose from infantry. We can also have command units, which usually there is only one, but we can also have like two units if we want to have that to increase the morale. We can have armored units. We can have support units. All these things we purchase in points, and these points are coming from victories, hopefully, and also are given a little bit random wise. Later on, if our commander survived and has a higher rank, we can also get elite units like guards and all this kind of stuff. We can also choose the quality of our units. This is experience. Conscripts is the lowest one, regular and elite. So all kinds of very interesting stuff here. Very nicely simulated. You can also check the units. You can see even their weapons, how many rounds they have in ammunition, if they're capable, for example, if they're capable of destroying a tank by sneaking close in and then assaulting it, and all this kind of stuff. And so it's a very detailed simulation. We now get it started here, and I think it's one of the most enjoyable game if you like historical strategy games. So I'm really looking forward for the new remake that Slytherin is working on. Here we have the mortar unit. The mortar unit we would just put far back so it cannot be assaulted by some kind of infantry unit. We want to have our anti-tank team. We put it here in the house, setting up an ambush together with our machine gun team here. They have a decent cover, not a very good one. Yellow doesn't mean that it's very good, but it's a decent one. Then we put lots of infantry units here in houses, making them also ambush anyone who will try to move this way and shooting them down. We will see there is a big difference in quality between Russian units and German units. German units are usually better at taking much more damage and are usually better also at shooting, causing damage. They also have the higher quality, but later on when we have our first Russian tanks, the German tanks have hardly any chance to destroy them because their armor is just so high. The only thing they can do is shoot at them like crazy and letting them rout. So, here we go. We will set all these teams on ambush. That means they will not shoot before we tell them to do so. And that should give us a nice surprise effect on the German units approaching us. Ambush. And where's our anti-tank team? It's very nicely hidden here. Come on. But two hidden that we can select, that's not too good. Come on, you guys just ambush as well. And ambush. And ambush. Okay, that's all we have to do. As we are the defenders, we will try to ambush. And we begin the battle here. We wait for the German units to approach us, and then we will try to shoot down as many as possible, hopefully destroying all of them. We have a fast game speed, which is correct for the start, as we will wait until we have the first contacts, and then the game will really get started here. So let's see what happens. And what they're gonna do. I'm not sure if this light infantry is really capable of assaulting a tank, are they? I think they are. But they're not the best ones. Anti-tank, well, okay. Still doable, but not very well. So we would have to sneak infantry to the side or to the back of a tank and then assault it from there and hopefully destroying it like this. That's the chance of the infantry. If the infantry is seen before, and that will happen if the tank has also some infantry. Ah, we're starting to spot enemies. Where? Has some infantry moving with them. That's why you never send out only tanks. Then they can spot the infantry and really shoot it down very easily. Ah, yeah, there is the enemy tank. Here we go. That is the strongest weapon they have, as we do not have any tank. We have to try to take it out with our 45mm AT gun. But we should only do that as soon as it's really in reach and not shoot too early. That's why I put these guys on ambush. Let's check it out. Could we fire at this guy? We could actually fire. We have a nice range. Okay. But I think it's not so effective from that range, right? No. We will not fire yet. We will wait until this tank will rather approach us. Okay, they sent an infantry. That's enjoyable for us. I will just move down the speed now. Why is it enjoyable? Because we have our mortar unit. And that mortar unit will just hopefully cause a lot of losses now shooting at these guys. Of course, also slowing them down quite a bit. So, here comes the mortar. Have fun with it, German infantry. You can see the mortar is not hitting very well. I think when they have higher XP, they get this through kills and through surviving in a scenario. They will do much better, though. Yeah, I wonder, should we already shoot at this tank? If this tank will start shooting at us, we are pretty much in trouble. Because this tank is a real killer. It's actually not a tank, it's a mixture of a tank and an artillery unit. Stuck. And so we really have to see what we want to do here right now. Okay, our mortar is shooting nicely, already suppressing this infantry a little. Not having done any hits yet, but that may come in time. Let's keep on shooting at them from here. As they try to approach. We will not start with our ambush. I think that was the first kill we did here, or at least we heard that person. Very nice. We will not start our ambush, as this Stuck is just waiting for us to show off where we are and then, I guess, bombard us from up there. So we will just use our motor and have fun with that. Okay, there's the next infantry unit approaching, but not close enough here to start the ambush. So, many infantry units. Let's just check what the tank will do if we start firing at them. As we can fire at them very nicely, they're not even in cover. We should actually kill some of them straight away like that. Come on. Yes. Also our infantry here. Shoot. Shoot at the infantry. That should actually shoot them into pieces. They should be in big trouble right now. With all the infantry shooting at them, them having much better cover than they have. So, this tank is not doing anything, but he's starting to approach, so we will wait with our anti-tank gun until we can have a few very nice shots at this tank. The problem with this tank is, it doesn't have any machine gun. Problem for the Germans, not for us. And it has to move around to be able to shoot at someone. Okay, I think it's taking its first shots there. So now we should be able also with our anti-tank gun to take a few shots too. And we can do it even from the side, hopefully hitting it nicely. If we hit it nicely, we can destroy it in one shot, I guess. Okay, let's see. We're doing pretty fine here. Our mortar together with all our infantry units are really giving these guys a big, big trouble. Yeah, this tank is shooting, but now what's happening to our anti-tank gun? Will you shoot this one down? Come on, guys. What are you doing? Are you still reloading? Yeah, okay. So, when will be the first shot from our anti-tank gun? Come on. Destroy the Stuck. Do it. The Stuck is doing quite some damage, but it doesn't have much ammunition, what I said, no machine gun. So it's not too much to worry for us here. Now, our anti-tank gun. Oh, they're even hitting it. It just seems to have a pretty good armor, decent armor. Wow! Now it gave big trouble to our anti-tank gun here. I guess we shot too early, because the Stuck seems to be very well capable of taking on our anti-tank gun with its armor. Too bad. Maybe we should have been really waiting and ambushing longer. Now we may not be able to actually take any shots from there anymore with our anti-tank gun. Too bad. But we surely do quite some damage to these guys here. So the infantry for sure will be in big time trouble all day long. Come on, let's keep on firing at them. And shoot all of them down as much as possible. Anti-tank gun. Oh, you're still reloading. Good. So that means you maybe can still take a few shots against this German tank here. I'm just amazed how bad the anti-tank gun is against the early German tanks. Well, well, well. That is, of course, not the best position for us now, when the anti-tank gun is having a hard time to even do any kind of damage. Let's do some mortar shooting. Wow! I think that was our anti-tank gun, right? Yeah. Yeah. Our anti-tank gun is history. Too bad. At least we do some damage to this light infantry here. And they will for sure not survive anything. Good. You guys, from very close by, should be able to destroy that tank up there. But we don't do anything right now.